PDFs that you can see here in this column, and these are what we call market line reports. Market line is a company that produces reports for mainly, if not all, publicly held companies, Fortune, Global, they're all in here. So those of you who wanted to do Nintendo, is that you? You probably can find Nintendo and Sony, but we're doing U.S. headquartered firms, okay? So let's just go to Starbucks. Look at that, I just happened to, and I must look up Starbucks a lot, if the default was there. So let's go to Starbucks and click on Starbucks, and you land here on this landing page that looks like you just looked up a scholarly report of some kind. So you have an abstract. That's not necessarily what you're looking for. You're looking for the PDF. But while we're here, because you're going to have a pretty rich bibliography of at least 10 major references, I would imagine that your market line report will be one of them. This little tab over here, this cite button, is something that you want to get used to. It's going to be on all of the Business Source Premier searches, and it's going to create your bibliography. I'm not going to show you the Business Source Premier cite button because it's pretty weak. It's only got the name and a date. I'll show you a better search citation in a moment. But let's open up the Market Line report, and you get this fabulous 74-page thing on Starbucks. Usually these are, if not always, published every year, so it's current as can be. The table of contents, as you can see, is hyperlinked to these specific areas. So you even have a SWOT analysis, something that we're going to be teaching you this week through discussion. I'm going to be teaching you again a more advanced SWOT analysis that will be part of your marketing plan. So company overview, key business, the business, not only the business description, but a little bit of history of the firm, key officers, and then analysis deeper into the paper. Basically, you learn everything you want to know in one report. So let's go back. Sometimes you have to have multiple tabs if you're doing library research, because especially in Business Source Premier, you can't touch the back. Like if I'm in here, if I go back, let's see where it takes us. See what happened? It didn't take us back to the main search. So once you're stuck in business, or once you're stuck in company profiles, you have to come back over here and relaunch the search. You with me? Questions about any of this? So Business Source Complete, the bottom. Company, more drop down, company profiles. Now that we're back here, let's do a little bit of scholarship. Let's do a search, and you're studying Starbucks. Anyone studying? Well, I kind of told you, I don't think we, I was a bit uneasy of you studying Starbucks because it doesn't have a very clear marketing voice. Remember that? But I'll use it as an example here. If I type in Starbucks and just push search, which is the world's worst search, let's see what we get. Looks like we have 11,793 searches. Let's narrow that down. Even just using the one word search, what just appeared is everything ever written about Starbucks. Newspaper articles, YouTube links, scholarly stuff, 11,000. If you come over here to the left panel, let's see where this date bar is. See that? Let's maybe drag this thing to more of a contemporary search, even to 2015. And that brings it to 5,000, not bad, it's a little better. But let's do some peer-reviewed. You know what a peer-reviewed article is? Have you heard that term? What is it? Yeah, let me teach you something real quickly. Everyone in this university, or many, not everyone, but most to many, research and write and publish. But what are we publishing? And here's the better question. The product of a university isn't you. The product is knowledge. Okay, this sounds a bit pretentious, but the product of this place is knowledge creation. And where does knowledge go? It maybe goes in books, it may be in other writings, but academic knowledge creation goes into academic journals. Now, who reads academic journals? On the one hand, nobody. On the other hand, academics, do you read them? I think you should, right, if you're going to be a true scholar of a discipline. But knowledge has to go somewhere. Anyone can write a book and publish a book. That's easy. Even self-publishing is a piece of cake. But you have to have, in order to get published in an academic journal, like the Journal of Marketing or the Journal of Consumer Behavior, that kind of stuff, it's a process. And it's a process because most of this knowledge stuff is, in many ways, scientific, if you will. And who uses science? Well, the world uses science to make decisions about doing things, building buildings, using biology and chemistry to understand all of the relations with pharmaceuticals and so on. So the point is, peers review your work, they test the rigor of it, put it through the test, maybe they'll say, this isn't really clear, revise and resubmit. So it's kind of a long process to get published. Can be, not always. But that's my point to you, is knowledge creation happens here. And in fact, that's the job of a professor, is to publish knowledge, okay? So we can read some of my knowledge later. Actually, I think I have a piece for you later in the course. So I just typed in the world's worst search, which is one word, Starbucks, clicked peer review, and we got, 138. See how we went from 11,000 to 138. This is an academic journal, as you can see. What's curious often, well, maybe it's just a search, is that it's not instantaneously available. You have to go get it. You see the get it tab? Well, let's try it. Let's go get it. Sometimes you might have to sign in. Very rarely do you have to sign in, but let's just see where get it takes us. Looks like it's available here. You can request it. It's either, maybe it's good, they can email it to you. Check Holdings at Rivera, download the PDF. All right, let's take a look at the PDF. So there you go, this is Management Science. The article is downloaded, well, by me, Publisher Institute of Operations Research in the Management Sciences. So that's the journal. Can you see it okay? Omnichannel Services, the False Premise and Operational Remedies. And there is your academic journal article. Pretty high level stuff, very qualitative and quantitative analytics to explain a Starbucks, let's go back, let's see what the title was. basically online shopping. Okay, follow? Let's go here to the site button, let's click on it. And you see the site button here? Right here is your bibliography right there. We're going to use APA formatting, APA 7th edition. So what you would do is you copy, paste this into your Word document, and there you go to begin your bibliography. Isn't that nice? I just saved you a lot of time. Questions about any of this? So this is in the, let's actually push back, see what happens. So it looks like it takes us back to the search thing. Clearly, you can do better searches than that. Maybe we can do Starbucks, and we type in consumer behavior. Watch this, I'm gonna even help you with your searches. See this select the field optional? If you click this, look at all of the things you can do. You can actually, so if we're looking at the Starbucks word, if you want Starbucks as the author's name, obviously that doesn't work, or the title of the periodical or whatever it is, if the title is Starbucks, or if it's a publication name, so you can really begin to hone in on your research searches. Even if you're a second year undergrad, okay, you're gonna be ahead of the game. That's database number one, business source complete. Any questions about this? Let's go back to the databases. And we're going to go to I. And we're gonna go to this thing called IBIS World at the top. Anyone been to IBIS World? Just you and me? Anyone else? I'm gonna change your line forever. Ready? Can you live without IBIS World? Where are you? You can live without it? No, you can't, just say no. Okay. So what's IBIS World? IBIS World is the world leading industry analysis database. So let's go look at IBIS World. If you went online and typed in ibisworld.com and tried to get one of these reports, you can do that, but it would probably cost you, depending on the kind of report, probably $5,000 to $10,000. This is a pretty powerful database. So this is what it looks like when you land here. Let's stick with Starbucks. Now, Starbucks is not an industry, but let's type in, search by industry keyword, company, or code. Let's type in Starbucks. Now, automatically, you see it starts to populate some options. Which do you think, and it even has more results. But let's just click search and see what it looks like here. You can go back for just a second. This, just leaving it there may be even more efficient. Which do you think, if you're studying Starbucks, makes the most sense as a potential industry to you? Probably a combination in food services might be a bit of a stretch. Coffee and snack shops in the U.S., that might be a good one. Coffee production, well, we're mostly interested in studying Starbucks, the company. Don't go to sleep, stay with me. The retail market for coffee in the US. So what do you think? Between this one and this one, which one do you want to look at? Retail market. This is, by the way, this OD6098 is a codification of this type of industry through IBIS World. So let's click on the market. The retail market for coffee in the US. This is a couple of, this is 2021, usually they're annual, so we'll have the 2022 coming up, probably within a short amount of time. But this is as good as it gets for the moment. So this is the digital landing page, but you can also go here and download a beautiful PDF. I use the PDF, well, I use this all the time, but I use the PDF all the time for a client or for a seminar or an intensive, because even business students like you, one of you has ever used this before, clients, the real world, have no clue about this. Imagine how much better and more competitive and strategic even a small business would be if they knew the analytics of their industry. Imagine that. So, what's going on here? Industry definition. Look at the navigation page for the column on the left. Let's look at industry at a glance. Let's just click there. Key statistics. Well, it looks like Starbucks, the industry of retail market coffee in the United States, is a $46 billion revenue generating industry. Don't you think that's important to get a real job? If you know that stuff, you with me? This isn't hilarious, are you with me? Okay. What do you know about the industry? Well, I know it's a $46 billion revenue generating industry. And you know, you list some of the signature pieces of the industry. You're gonna get the job instantaneously, I guarantee it. So what's going on in here? What are the key drivers? Percentages, industry structure. Looks like profit is a bit thin from the last 5 years, the projections, look at profitability. How many businesses are in this industry? Looks like a lot, 342,000. It employs 2 million people, 7 billion in wages. This is market share, look at this. Looks like Starbucks has 33% market share. Dunkin', which you may not have known, has 15% market share. And then look at all of this, there's everybody else. 50% of all coffee shops in the United States are, you know, other brands. Now you have a sense of context. You can't produce a marketing plan or a strategic plan, we'll call it, or make any decisions, I think, at all without knowing the position you are within an industry. It's industry performance. How is the industry performing? Everything you ever wanted to know about charts and graphs, industry outlook. So, guess what you get to do? You need to make a decision immediately about the company that you're going to study. You're going to need to go get the company report. You're going to go need to get the industry report. Why not get two industry reports, right? You can get related industry reports, maybe the one that seems the most specific. Questions? IBIS World. How often do you use IBIS World? Very often. Where are you going to be working? Huh. Got a job right after business school, did you? Nice. Okay. Let's go back to the databases. And let's go to, what was the first database? Nice. What was the second one? What's the third one? You haven't said it yet. M for money. M. Kind of fun to like just take a look at these things here. We're gonna go to Mergent Online. How many of you have ever been to Mergent Online? Not one of you. Okay, I hope there are three feelings and emotions happening upon you. Number one, the first one is that you're tired. You can barely keep your head up. That's okay. You're tired, and that's one emotion. I don't know if emotion is being tired is an emotion, but you know what I mean. The second one is, gee, sure would have been nice if I knew this stuff maybe as a freshman, maybe at a freshman orientation. But never mind, don't be bitter. The third one is, gee, I'm sure glad I know it now. My life has changed forever. M, Mergent Online. I know it's tiny, but it's as good as it's gonna get. So follow me closely, look up on the screen. This is a landing page, kind of, if you can see, it's live. We've got the timestamp, the exact time right over here. This is I think among the most powerful databases for all things financial. I'm going to show you a couple of things. While we're here, you can do something else, which is kind of neat. You see down here where it says country profile? If you're studying international stuff, you can click here, any country in the world, and do a little company or country profile. Let's see how, pick your, let's go to Ukraine. So this is, you want to be very careful when you look up some of these things. You can see that this is a 2019 country report. What's happened since then? Well, an entire pandemic and now an invasion war. Why hasn't there been an updated country profile? The researchers cannot get in the country. Just a little interesting factoid. All right, I don't know if we can push the back button. Looks like we can. All right, so here's a couple of things. Look at the light green tabs here. Government filings, that's kind of cool. Bond search, country insight, economic research. We're not necessarily going there, but you can see the value-added tabs at the top. Let's type in a company. Gee, let's do Starbucks. Now look what happens. You start to get the stock ticker and a couple of options here. We're not interested in Starbucks Coffee Japan. We're interested in Starbucks Corporation. Click on it, and then you land on this rather comprehensive page. You get a business summary. You can do a little stock price. Let's look at the stock price of the last year. Looks like it's sort of held between 80 and 90, 100, let's say 110 per share. You just click it in 2 seconds. Can you get this stuff from other internet sites? Sure, but nothing like this, what I'm about to show you. Okay, let's take a look up at the top. Who did I ask about market cap on Monday? Who are you pointing to? Someone behind you? What's market? Was it you? What is it?